I should never be allowed to type in a tutorial. Okay. Hello, welcome back to another tutorial. In today's video, I want to show you how you can use a site called the Bug Squasher. And the site does basically what it says it is. It helps you squash bugs on websites, but also allows you to streamline communication amongst teams, clients, and projects. So the people of the Bug Squasher have sent me a test account to use for this video. Let's go ahead and get started. So just real quick, some features of the Bug Squasher include simple installation, easy reporting, a universal tool, efficient team and client communication, secure squashing abilities, and you can record, which is new, snip and click images into a report. And this works on WordPress, any type of website framework. And for more information on what it is, again, you can go to their website. All right, let's get into this. So I'm gonna go into my account. So when you buy a account, the first thing you'll need to do is add a site, and you can do that by clicking add new site. There's another way of doing it, but whatever. And you'll put in the name of the site as well as the URL, and you'll click add site. And then you can choose your plan, subscription frequency, if you have a coupon code, your site, your card number, and all that, and then you'll click get plan. But like I said, the people of the Bug Squasher have generously given me an account to use, and we are going to go ahead and use that. So in your panel, you will need to copy this line of code, and then I'm going to use this on a WordPress site. I am logged into the site I'm going to use. Then I need to come over to Appearance Editor. Then in my particular theme, it is a child theme of the parent theme. You know, that's how families work. Child's parents. Anyway, so I need to actually go into my parent theme, which is not this one, but is instead, boop, hit select. Then I need to come into my theme header, and then I will find my slash head tag and paste the code from the Bug Squasher right before that tag. I have already done so. Once you update everything by hitting update file, then this is what it'll look like on your website. It will just be this little thing that floats. So let's say I'm a client and I am exploring a website like I just did. And then I see that there's something wrong. I can submit a bug. The first question it'll ask is for your name and email. So if you're gonna submit a bug, maybe do this on your own computer, because otherwise, if someone else were to come along onto a public computer where you have done this, now anyone can use your email and name and whatnot, and that's minorly problematic. Granted, I'm the only one who uses my computer, so that's how I'm seeing it. So maybe that's one thing that people at the Bug Squasher could fix. Up to them, just a thought. Moving on. So you can upload a screenshot. So if you've already taken a screenshot using something else or using whatever's built in into your computer, then you can upload it there, or you can take a screenshot. Okay, it says taken and saved. Or you can use a snipping tool, take a screenshot of it, just a portion of a website. I'm not going to do that. And this is the new feature. Now, probably when you click this, it will ask you to install a Google Chrome extension so you can record a bug that is on a website. So I'm going to hit record, hit OK. I have two screens going on. Hit share, and it will start to record your screen. So I can scroll down, and if you haven't done this but prior, it may ask for access to your microphone. Granted, I have the microphone plugged in, but you know, I have no bug to report or anything to talk about. I'm just gonna keep moving up and down the screen. When we are done, we can hit stop, and then we can review and see what it's like, and I can hit done. This will probably take a little bit of time because that's just kind of how video works. So we're just gonna sit here and wait for a bit. So once your video is done, then it creates a URL that can then be seen in the report, and I'll get to that later. We can summarize our bug. We can also select the bug urgency. You can just say, hey, I found a thing, trap and contain the bug, or squash now because this is of utmost importance. Once we are done, we can then click squash this. So thank you for catching that bug. And forms are sent to your Bug Squasher account immediately. So I can come over to my account, click all bugs, and it will show the report. I can click report. Then I can see the site that it is on. I can assign it to someone. if I actually had people on my team. I can select a due date, so I want this taken care of by this time. I can report the status, in progress, yada yada, add notes, and then this is the report information. Has the user's name, user email, blah blah blah. But here is the screenshot that we took earlier, shows the page that this happened on, which is the home page, and it even has our video that we recorded. And you can color code if you so desire. And then once you have taken care of the bug, then you can of course hit update bug. And if you've done any adjustments or dealt with it, you can hit update bug. You can also add bug tags to categorize bugs found on your website. You can also add team members. You can create name. You put in their name, email address, password, and confirm. And here they have a link to install the Chrome extension that I mentioned earlier for doing video recordings of bugs. And if you have any questions, they have a very handy setup guide. These are all GIFs. Trust me, here's how to add the bug squasher to your website, or it just tells you basically to copy paste the code that I mentioned earlier in this video. Add team members, get notifications, and set up the report page are all tabs under here. Again, restricted access, and you can record video with the Chrome extension. And if you have an idea or a request, or if you need to contact support, you can just do so at that email there. Now, the unfortunate reality is that since this is a site that not many people use, including the people I set it up for, there is not really any bugs to report on, and there's nothing exciting to see in this tutorial. But that is how this very useful tool works. So if you think that the bug squasher might be right for you and might be super helpful for your website and your team, then you can go check out all their informational videos and other informational sites and such in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you can give it a big thumbs up. You can click right over here to subscribe to the respective channels, and you can click right over here to see my previous video. And as always, I'll see you in the next tutorial.